In this case study, we are going to touch on the following topics: timeline management, specifically grouping of features, and order of operations, using bodies as cutting tools. The aim here is to create this model with a series of cross-cutting slots and a cylindrical cut in the middle with a chamfered edge. This feature will be the focus of our discussion. Let's begin this discussion by trying to look at the potential problems we face if we try to add a chamfer as the last feature. So I have pre-modeled this with the exception of the chamfer feature. We started out with a sketch rectangle to create the main body. These slots were created using the pattern on path feature. Lastly, a cylindrical cut was made. Before adding in the chamfer, let's try to clean up this timeline by grouping the related steps together. This will make things easier for us later. Let's group the sketch rectangle and the main body extrude by control selecting the two features, right clicking, and going to create group. With that, the features will be consumed into this group represented by an icon that looks like three small rectangles. You can expand the group by clicking on the plus sign. Right click and rename the group main body. Next, control select the features responsible for creating the slots and group them together. This will include the sketch, extruder cut, and pattern on path features. We shall rename the group pattern. Do the same for the cylindrical cut. We have now grouped the timeline into the three main steps: the main body, the criss-crossing pattern, and the cylindrical cut. Next, go to Modify, Chamfer, and start picking on the appropriate edges. So it looks like we have achieved what we have set out to do. So what happens if we change the location of the cylindrical cut? Expand the group and locate the sketch circle. Right-click on the sketch and go to Edit Sketch. Let's move the circle to another location. As we exit the sketch, the chamfer feature turns red, indicating a compute failure. We can right-click and go to Review Warning. There are two things causing the failure here. Remember how we selected individual entities to create the chamfer? These entities were created by the way the cylindrical cut intersected with the cells created by the criss-crossing pattern. Once we shifted the circle sketch, a fresh new set of entities was created, resulting in lost references. Another reason might be that a shift in the circle resulted in thin slivers of material that could not be chamfered properly. With the current state of the model, whenever we make adjustments to the circle sketch, we would probably need to open up the chamfer feature to make adjustments. Ideally, we want to have a parametric model that will regenerate successfully whenever we make adjustments. We need a better way to create the chamfer. The main issue here is that we are trying to create the chamfer after the crisscross pattern was done, which meant dealing with multiple entities. At this point, it should become clear that we need to do the cylindrical cut and chamfer before the crisscrossing pattern. Let's delete the chamfer feature. We need to reorder the timeline such that the cylindrical cut happens before the criss-cross pattern. Go to the timeline, click and drag the cylindrical cut group to before the pattern group. Look out for the vertical line to make sure that you are in the correct position before letting go of the mouse. Let's go to the beginning of the timeline and advance it step by step. The cylindrical cut is now before the criss-cross pattern. The earlier effort to group features has made it easier for us to reorder the timeline. Shift the playhead to after the cylindrical cut and before the crisscross pattern. Add the chamfer feature here. We only need to select one entity. The chamfer is now referenced to a single unchanging entity, which is the edge of the circular cut, and is not affected by the crisscross pattern. With this change in the order of the timeline, we have made the model much more flexible to future changes. Let's make this more challenging. Suppose that we have been handed an important model with the slots already cut in, and now we are tasked with making the cylindrical cut with the chamfer, and we have to make it parametric. instead of thinking of making chamfers of multiple entities, is there a way to achieve this in a single step? A chamfer is, after all, just an angled cut. Is there a way to make an angled cut all around a circular path? We can make use of the revolve cut with such a profile. Yet another way is to think of creating a body to act as a tool. We can create a cylinder with a chamfered edge as such. During the extrude feature, this was created as a new body. Looking at the cross section, the two bodies overlap each other. We will use this newly created body to cut into the main body. Go to Modify, Combine. Choose the main body as a target body and choose the cylinder as the tool body.